Hi, my name is Simon Howard, and I'm a solution architect at Micro Focus. This video is about one of the ways in which you can use Fortify Static Code Analyzer to scan code. And that's by basically scanning code in a script or at the command line level. Before we do that first, let's talk about what happens under the hood when you scan code. So when you scan code using Fortify SCA, you give the tool your application source code files and dependency files. Then there are two stages to our scanning process. First, we translate those files, those source code files and dependencies, into NST files, normalized IAST syntax tree files. And then having done that, then we run a second stage, which is the analysis stage. And we run your code essentially through a set of 8 analyzer engines. And each of those engines serve a specific process to find different types of vulnerabilities. Now, to find those vulnerabilities, we use rules. Rules are part of rule packs, and that's how they're deployed. There are two different types of rules. There are rules that essentially come off the shelf that are created in XML by our security research group. And then there are client-developed rules, which are essentially rules that you can develop yourself using much the same tools that our SRG team use. When the analysis has completed, an FPR file is generated. So that summarizes the scanning process. So let's go do a scan. So when you install Fortify SCA, you get a set of sample applications, a basic and advanced. And we're going to scan one of those. And to do a scan at the command line level or in a script, you have to run a tool called Source Analyzer. Now, Source Analyzer has a set of command line parameters available that you can use with it. And this is an extract, or rather the section in the user guide for SCA that describes the command line options. And there are quite a lot of them. If I scroll very quickly through that, you can see there are options of different types. Now, in order to do this scan, what I've actually done is I've written a little batch file to make it nice and quick in Windows itself. Let's go look at that. So here's the source file analyzer command being run. -B specifies a build ID, kind of like a project, if you like. Clean says clean out any previous data associated with that build ID. I'm using on the next two lines then, and I'm using wrap, it's wrapped in the editor here. The first stage, I'm running the translation to generate those NST files. And the second stage, where I'm calling a source analyzer, I am basically generating the results. So there's some commands here that are used, or parameters rather, used to specify, in this case, where some jar files are and source code files. This is a Java project with a mixture of different types of programming languages. And then the last stage, I'm just saying, I haven't got that, generate this FPR file. So let's go run that and see what happens. Now, I've already got a command line window open at the right place. Here are the files. And I'm just going to run scan.bat. So right now, we're cleaning that build ID, just in case there are any previous data from previous scans. Now I'm running through the translation stage. Now, I've got the verbose option turned on, so you've seen it actually processing the files. You don't have to have that, obviously. Notice it's processing all the Java files right now. Now JSP files. Now some JavaScript files. Also processing HTML, you can see up there as well. And now it's actually running the second stage of the actual scan, which is the analysis. Now it's actually starting to do the analysis itself. Now in this particular scan, we're obviously running through the different analyzer engines, looking for different types of vulnerabilities. Getting towards the end of the scan now. And there you go, the scan is now complete. So if we do a quick DIR again, you can see we now have an FPR file. That is the results file we talked about. The next stage would be to look at the results within one of our other tools, such as Audit Workbench, or to look at it in SSC, Software Security Center, in a collaborative mode with your colleagues within your team, or indeed to do other things like generate report and so on. There's all sorts of use cases there. This is just one way in which you can do a scan. This is, if you like, at the lowest level. We typically might do it at the command line level or within a script, but there are many other ways to do a scan. Okay, great. See you in the next video.